Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is your man of God, Bishop W.J. Campbell, coming to you live and in living color on its web TV, www.itswebtv.com. Amen. Or you can call us here at the station. We're doing this broadcast live. It's area code 248-996-8954. That's 248-996-8954. Matter of fact, call someone. Tell someone that Bishop W.J. is live and in living color. You know, you can see me. Have me in your living room or in the kitchen. Don't take me in the bedroom. Just let me stay in the living room and in the kitchen. Somebody said, well, Bishop, I my computer's in the bedroom. Well, if that's the case, then so should it be. Amen. Praise God. But listen, seriously, I thank God for you. Amen. We have to have a little humor. Amen. So this is what it's about. And be able to enjoy yourself. And amen. And at the same time, be diverse and just say, hey, I'm just letting the Spirit of God flow within. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. God is good all the time. Amen. Praise. We come to share with you good news in my Father's kingdom. Amen. Praise God. On this another Monday, amen, the 16th of May, if my memory is right. Praise God. Amen. Now, June. This is June. Hey, I'm sleeping a month. Praise God. I done went back a month. 16th of June. Amen. 17th of June. See, I'm still off a little bit. Amen. Praise God. But I got it right now. The 17th of June. Amen. Praise God. We coming to you live and living color. Amen. Praise God. Listen, I want you to go into the Word of God quickly. I'm going to just read from the book of Psalms. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Before we go into our broadcast. Amen. And I want to have your undivided attention just a little while. For him of the pathway with the Word of God should stand forever. Amen. And we just want to acknowledge God, first of all, that being so good to us, enable us to be able to have this telethon broadcast on its web TV to come into your homes, your automobile sick rooms, where it might be, just to tell you of the good things that God has in store for you. Amen. In the book of Psalms, the 71st version of Psalms, amen, praise God, I want to read just about six verses for your spiritual upliftment. Amen. It says, 71st verse of Psalms, amen, praise God. In you, O Lord, I put my trust. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness and cause me to escape. Incline your ear to me and save me. Be my strong refuge to which I may resort continually. You have given the commandment to save me, for you are my rock and my fortress. Deliver me, O God, out of the hand of the wicked, out of the hand of the unrighteous and cruel men. Verse 5, for you are my hope, O Lord. God, you are my trust from my youth. Verse 6, but you have been held from birth. You are he who took me out of my mother's womb. My praise should be continually of you. Verse 7, I become a wonder to many, but you are my strong refuge. Verse 8, let my mouth be filled with your praise and with your glory all the day. Verse 9, do not cast me off in the time of old age. Do not forsake me when my strength fails. Verse 10, for a man that speaks against me and those who lie is waiting for my life like counsel together. Verse 11. Say, good, forsake me. Pursue and take him, for there is none to deliver him. Verse 12. O God, do not be far off from me. O my God, make haste to help me. I read you verse Psalm 71, reading Psalm from verse 1 through 12. May there be a blessing and to reading God's word. Amen. Saints of God, I'm so happy that I'm able to come and share with you the good news in my Father's kingdom. Amen. And tell you that you can make it if you try. Amen. Praise God. And to know that there's nothing too hard for God. Amen. Praise God. I find today that there are many of the saints of God are not able to provide for their family the way they would like to. For some of them, the income not like it has been. Many of you are robbing Peter, trying to pay Paul, and you just living from day to day. Amen. But we thank God for that. Amen. For he's an on-time God. See, the more you give him the praise, amen, the more God will do for you. Amen. See, you don't know when God is going to come and open that door, but we know he can do it in a twinkling of an eye. See, you have not because you ask not. In my Father's house there's plenty. Because we know, realize one thing, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. Amen. I want to talk to you about a man in biblical time, amen, that, hallelujah, he wants to know how he can be saved. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Born again. Hallelujah. Praise God. And I want you to have your Bibles. Go with me to John. John, hallelujah, the book of John, praise God, the third chapter, amen, and we want to read from the book of John, third chapter. I'm going to just go and read some verses for your spiritual edification so that you would understand exactly where I'm coming from, praise God. See, God wants me to reassure you that whatever you're praying for or about, you can have, or it can come to pass. Long as you have the faith and believe, then it will happen. If you don't believe it, it can't happen. Amen. It's according to your faith. Praise God. And we know what the word of faith comes from. Everything, faith, come by hearing the word of God. Amen. So that's the evidence about your faith. If things are evident and things not seen. Amen. So, but we know God is a good God. We know God is an blessing. We know that God is a healer. We know that God can take the foolish thing and confound the wise. So we know that. Amen. So from the word of God, take it from the book of John, third chapter, verse 1. There was a man of the Pharisee named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher, come from God. Amen. For no one can do these things, to no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him. Jesus answered and said to him, most assured, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said to him, "How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Most assured and say unto you, unless one is born of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God." Then he goes on to verse 6 and says, "That which is born of flesh is flesh, that which is born of spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I say unto you, you must be born again. The wind blows where it wish, and you hear the sound of it, but you can't tell where it's coming from or where it goes. So it is everyone who is born of the Spirit." Listen what Nicodemus answered. Nicodemus answered and said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered and said unto him, "You are a teacher of Israel, and do not know these things. Most assuredly I say to you, we speak what we know, and testify what we have seen. You do not receive our witness. If I told you earthly things, you would not believe. How would you believe if I told you heavenly things? No one has sent to heaven, but he come down from heaven. That is the Son of Man who is in heaven." Listen, saints of God. Nicodemus was one with authority. Nicodemus didn't want people to see him, so that's why he came to Jesus by night. When you're in a position and you have men upon you, that you tell them what do and they do it, amen, when they come and when they go. Amen. So you don't want anybody to know that, hallelujah, you know, when you're doing something, hallelujah. So that's why you got to do it a certain time of hour or night. So by Nicodemus having this, being in the authority stature that he had, he didn't want anyone to know that he was coming to Jesus when he came by night. Amen. But his main concern was, how can he be born again? That was his question. Lord, how can I be born again? And Nicodemus was confused because he said, "Here I am, an old man. I can't go and be born through my mother's womb again. So how can I be born again?" And verse 5, listen to what Jesus told him. Jesus answered and said this, "Most assured I said to you, unless you are born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God." Did you hear what I said? You must be born of the water and of the Spirit. If you're not, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Then it goes on to say, "That which is born of flesh is flesh, that which is born of spirit is spirit." So it's telling Nicodemus, listen, if you want to be born again, it's got to be of the water and of the Spirit. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Listen, saints of God, what about you? Have you been born again? Have you been born again? I want to ask you that question. Have you been born again? Do you accept your Lord and Jesus Christ as your Savior? If you can say yes to that, I applaud you. I thank God for you. From tuning in. See, we want those that love the Lord. Those that made him their personal savior. those that pick up their sleeve and go in the vineyard and do God's will. Go and tell someone of the good thing that God will do for those that believe in him. Oh, you don't hear me? I don't know about you, but whatever you're going through right now, God can turn things around in your life if you believe in him. Oh, come on, Holy Ghost, work with me. Praise God. Someone's on the verge of just giving up right now. But I heard the Lord said, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven, and all thy righteousness shall be added unto you. See, God knows what you're going through already, and God wants to make it all right for you if you let him in. Why not surrender to him right now? Say, Lord, here am I. Lord, make me the way you want me to be. Take the old self out of me, Lord, and let your newness flow in. For you are my all in all. Praise God. So what we got to do, saints of God, get ready for the news that God has for you. Amen. Praise God. We're in the half of a year right now. This is June the 17th. So we look around and June will be gone. Some of us have not even moved the winter clothes and brought all the summer clothes. Amen. But nevertheless, we have to condition our mind and move all the garbage, all the cobwebs out of our mind so we can feel the Spirit of God moving freely within. I thank God for the spiritual uplift in me. I thank God for the spirit that he has given me to move and direct me. I thank God for giving me a mind that's already made up. Praise God. And Lord, I'm going to serve you. Praise God. Lord, I'm going to do your will. Praise God. I don't care how long or hard it takes. You right now that's watching this particular broadcast, you're saying, Lord, I just don't know what's wrong in my life, but I know it didn't used to be like this. Lord, I need direction. I need some help to get me out of the mess that I'm in. Jesus said, come, all you that have laid in, lean on him, he'll give you rest, and make thy yoke easy. In my Father's house, there's plenty of everything. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? In the book of Proverbs 3:5-6, acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. So we must acknowledge God as being the head of our life, and he will direct our path as we travel down life's highway. Jesus is the best thing that has happened to me. God is a good God. God is all I need. David said he was the apple of God's eye. Oh, praise the Lord today. Saints of God, I want you that's tuning in this very moment, praise God. Perhaps you just tune in. Amen. Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. This is Bishop W.J. Campbell, that you listen, known to many of you radio land as Bishop W.J. Amen. And I just want to tell you that, hey, honey, listen, we're tuning it up and tuning it down because Jesus is on the main line. Call him up and tell him what you want. He's a healer. He's a deliverer. He's a doctor. He's a door opener. He's all that you need. He's a lawyer. So whatever you need today, God is it. All you got to do is give yourself to him and say, Lord, I'm ready to receive whatever you have for me. Amen. Listen, I'm going to come back and we're going to go a little deeper. See, it's all about you today. See, if you don't want nothing out of life, you won't get nothing. Amen. See, you have to want something out of life. You see, nobody going to drop anything in your lap. Amen. You might be saying, I'm going to hit the lottery. Amen. Daydreaming. Don't work that way. You have to have an open mind and a made up mind and determine. If you don't put nothing in the pot, you can't get anything out the pot. Amen. Somebody said, I worked all my life and I still ain't got nothing. But God can make a difference. I'll be right back. I want you to watch this commercial about those blessed angels. And I want you to have one. Quiet supply lasts. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Listen, I don't know about you, but I'm so excited right now to know what God can do. See, in life, we all have challenges sometimes. Or things gets in our way. Amen. It causes us to miss out on the opportunity that comes our way. But we can rest assured that God always make a way for those that stand firm in his word. Amen. See, the kingdom of God is at hand right now. And the only thing you got to do is go forth. Amen. Go forth. Amen. Because it says here in Matthew, the 6th chapter. Amen. Praise God. The 9th verse. In this manner, therefore, pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debtors, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Praise God. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come. I remember before I would go to bed, I would say that prayer. It was a must. It's the way I was brought up. Our Father in heaven. We as saints of God must realize today that we can go to the Father any time of day or night. And he's always there with open arms. I know today that he's concerned about you and I because we are his children. Amen. But if we travel down life's highway, sometimes we get off the track and try to take another detour. But when God touches you, he won't let you stray too far. And he'll pull you right back and put you back on the right course. I'm saying to someone right now that's listening to this telephone, sitting at home, rocking in your easy chair, on your computer, you tune in. Eyes have not seen. Ears have heard a good thing that God has in store for those that believe in him. It's all right to be down, but don't stay down. It's all right to want and don't have, but don't want too long. See, we serve in our right now God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the Prince of Peace, the Lily of the Valley, Yahweh, Jehovah. Whatever you call him, he is my all in all. God the Father, the Creator of all. To him I give the praise. To him I give the glory. But when you know that, then you don't have to worry about when your back is against the wall. Know this one thing, I'm coming out. Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. I'm coming out because God is the head of my life. God is my refuge. He is my supplier. He's my maker. Hallelujah. See, when you know that, you say, devil, I got to back you up to the wall because you can't hold me down any longer. I refuse. My God. Saints of God. In life, as we travel this journey that we're on, God wants to make you strong in Him. God wants to let you be knowledgeable that He can bring you out of whatever you're going through. Amen? Hallelujah. And all you got to do is be persistent. Some of y'all, you're not persistent. And when things does not work out the way you want, when you give in, you give up. You have to be persistent. Say, I know what my God, I know God's going to bring me. I know He's going to deliver me. It's just a matter of time. Listen, I encourage all of you to stand with me. Stand firm with me. And as we pray a petition towards the Almighty God, for the Spirit of God spoke to my mind and told me just to share the word. The word of God is like a magnet upon your feet. The word of God like a glow, a halo over your head. The word of God makes things happen in your life. The word of God changes your surrounding or your situation. The word of God. The word of God makes things happen. Oh, you'll hear me. How many need something to happen in your life right now? How many of you are tired of going doing the same old 369? And not getting anywhere, not making any progress, then you need to change. Why not fresh yourself with the word? Let the word of God mellow things out in your life. Praise God. That woman, that man that's listening, that's seeing me right now, you say, I wish I had a little more income. I wish that my funds were a little more better than what they are. I wish I didn't have this bill that's paid. I'll feel better. Someone have an illness or sickness that caused you to spend out a lot of money that you wasn't wish you didn't have to do. The insurance paid so much, but you had to come out of your pocket. Remember, God's able. God is able. God is able. Amen? And when God is able, then good things happen this week. This week, I want to share with you the word from on high. Listen very carefully. When you let the word of God penetrate and root down in your spirit, or I need somebody to pray for now, then something gonna start brewing up and it will get full. Hallelujah. And something good is going to happen. An explosion. That's what the word of God does. It brings excitement. Good things happen. Whatever you desire. But let the word of God fulfill your desire that you are praying about. Now, let me rephrase it. Let the word of God fulfill that emptiness. Does it make sense? Let the word of God fulfill that. Whatever emptiness that you have in your life, let the word of God. God said, He will enable your cup to overflow. David said, the Lord anointed my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Well, you ain't praying with me. Now, if we take that and apply the word, because it says this in the book of Genesis, in the beginning was the word, and the word was God. And it should not come back void, but what? Accomplish that was sent. And I want the word of God to accomplish that what it's sent to do for you. Listen, saints of God, I don't care where you live. Somebody up there in Canada, Florida, Tennessee, Alabama, Georgia, Illinois, Missouri, California. Hallelujah. Somebody in Dakota, New York, Arizona, Mexico. Somebody over there in the Bahamas. Praise the Lord. But you are in need of God's help. Because right now, things are at a standstill. I want to send you the blessings from on high. I want to send you the blessings from on high. And the word of God does exactly that. I need somebody to pray with me. I said again, the word of God does exactly that. His word goes forth and good things happen. Do you want something good to happen for you? Do you want that door to open that's been closed in your face? Do you want success to flow in? Are you tired of getting right there at the door and still can't move forward? Stop right now and get a pen and paper at hand and write me a special letter. Write me a special letter. And that important mail address is simply this: Bishop W.J. That's a W and a J. P.O. Box 21113. Detroit, Michigan. Zip 48221. That's P.O. Box 21113. Detroit, Michigan. Zip 48221. I'm saying to you that's watching this broadcast, I'm saying to you that seeing the broadcast, if there was ever a time that you needed things to break, then the time is right now. I want you to address a letter and do it quickly and prayerfully. It's not a maybe situation, it's an urgent situation. Because I know the word of God is going to make a difference. I know the word of God is going to dry the tears that's been coming down your cheeks. I know the word of God is going to enable you to go and tell the creditors that, listen, I want to pay this bill off, so I won't owe you anymore. The word of God can do it. And the only thing you got to do is do this. Be simple. Write me. Oh, you can, you're listening right now, and you can feel the Spirit of the Lord telling you right now, why not take this opportunity? Because tomorrow could be too late. That's why you're in the rut you're in. Because you did not move as the Spirit of God spoke direct to you. And I'm saying to you right now, God knows your heart. And that's why the Spirit of God had you to tune in to this special broadcast right now, because the help you need is at hand. Oh, somebody right now. Listen, it's simple. Write down this mail address right now. It's not a whole lot you have to do. My God is able. God would use a jackass and bless the saints of God if they have an open mind. God Almighty. Oh, somebody right now. See, I know what the word of God is awesome. It blessed men and saints of old. It can bless you. But first you got to forget about this and that. You got to put yourself in the position. Say, I want God to bless me through the word. Listen to me. That important mail address is simple. I'm going to do it slow. Because sometimes I talk a little faster, and sometimes you cannot write as fast as I talk. So for you, I'm going to do it very slow. Write me, Bishop, W, the letter W, and a J. Now that's P.O. Box 21113. Detroit, Michigan. Zip 48221. Now, in order for us to keep coming your way, telling you of the good news, we ask your support to sow a seed of faith into this ministry. I've had some to send 100, some send 50, some even 20, some even less. But that's not the point. The point is how you want God to bless you. What can you give from your heart? That's what counts. And certainly, God already knows what you're able to do. You can run, but you can't hide. So you can tell me anything, but God knows. But I'm saying to you right now, if there was ever time that you want a breakthrough to take place. You don't know me and I don't know you. But as the Spirit of God is saying right, you should write WJ today. And I declare, you'll be happy, rejoicing, like you never have been before. I mean, listen, you say, oh, it's been a long time. Because I serve an on-time God. Listen, I'm going to take a break, and I'm going to come back. And with the excitement of why that you need to get on board, I'll be right back. And watch it about the advertised about the angels, the blessed angel, that you need to have one in your home that's going to help you with many of your problems you're facing right now. God bless. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Listen, saints of God, those of you that's listening to this, watching this particular broadcast right now, they're in your homes. And this is serious business. Because there are someone right now that you don't have to be in the situation you're in, but you are not taking thoughts as the Spirit gives them to you. Otherwise, just like this, you're letting things get away from you. And still you're taking what the Spirit of God gives you moving forth, you let that second guess comes in. Amen. But I want to simplify this with you. When the word of God go forth, good things happen. It's like a lamp under the bottom of your feet. Because when you're trying to seek the word of God, you can rest assured that though the demonic spirit will get busy, some call it Satan, the opposite forces get busy trying to hinder you from receiving what God wants you to receive. But when you're anchored in the Lord whole heart and solely, Satan can't penetrate in. God's got an answer far better than none this week. Why it's important is that you take time out right now. I'm talking being delivered. I'm talking being blessed. I'm talking being able to meet your responsibility that's been holding you down. Weight on your shoulders, because you're not able to function the way you has been in the past, because things are not going well. Oh, I'm talking to somebody. Amen. I'm not trying to put your business in the street, but otherwise, your income is not plentiful as it has been. Someone not working many hours on their job. Many things have happened. But my God will supply all of your needs according to his riches in heaven. This week, you need the word. You need to write me for the word from on high. And I declare it's going to make a difference. It's going to make a difference in your life. Write me, Bishop W.J. Bishop W.J. That's P.O. Box 21113, Detroit, Michigan, 48221. I'm asking you to sow that seed of faith into this ministry. I'm asking some send 100, some send 50, some send 25, some send less. Be obedient to your spirit. And whatever you're going to send it in the spirit of love. And watch. Just watch and see what God goes. I declare, deliverance coming to your house. Good is finna flow back in where evil has been rooting in. We're going to kick Satan to the curb. We're going to kick him clean out the house. He can't stay there any longer, because the word of God is coming directly to you. We invite you every Sunday. We have a praise service at our church here in Detroit, Michigan. That address, 15819 Wyoming. Divine Deliverance, if you're in the area, if you're here in Detroit on Sunday, and you want to come out and worship with us, we welcome you with open arms. This is a church where everybody, somebody's non-denomination, and we just give praise to the Almighty God for being so good to us. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Incidentally, on Wednesday, we have our praise service from 8 to 12. Amen. A special prayer session. If you need prayer, amen. If you want to come in and pray, amen. You're more than welcome, amen. From 8 to 12. And at 7 p.m. that evening, we have our Bible study. Amen. So, in that note, we ask you to come in and be a part of our Bible study. 15819 Wyoming, Divine Deliverance Church. Amen. For everybody is somebody. We don't have no big chiefs, no big youths. Everybody is the same. Amen. Listen, look like time is sort of winding down on me. Amen. And I've enjoyed this opportunity just to be able to come in your home and just to sit back with you. Amen. And we're just trying to move those sin clean out of that house. Praise God. Kick him out. He's been there too long. I got the word of God I'm going to send you. It's going to make a difference. And the only thing you got to do is jump on board. Don't let this train pass you by without being on board this week. Because, honey, if you get on board, you're going to be delivered. Listen, right in this week for the word. To Bishop W.J., P.O. Box 21113, Detroit, Michigan, zip 48221. And I declare, when the last time you had a smile on your face because you were so happy that something good happened to you? Well, I can tell you this one thing. If you write me this week for the word from on high, you're going to have a smile on your face all the way to the bank. Hallelujah. And one thing about it, you'll be able to say the next individual, man didn't do this, God did. Listen, write me. Bishop W.J., P.O. Box 21113. P.O. Box 21113, Detroit, Michigan, zip 48221. And I got a feeling deep down in my spirit that if you write me this week, hallelujah, you're going to be, oh my God Almighty, you be saying, can't touch this. Hallelujah. Because God has been a deal for you. We love you. And we're praying with you. Peace be unto you. Praise the Lord. God bless you.